Throughout Earth's history, different natural events have entirely changed the shape of continents all over the planet. Some of these events are related to geological activity and take several million years. However, other changes occur in much shorter periods. Some of these occur during a human lifetime, and we could see them before the year 2100. But what events could bring about such a drastic change in maps worldwide? Keep watching to find out. Five, sea level rise. This is perhaps one of the most significant challenges facing humanity in the 21st century, and it has the potential to drastically change the world's maps by 2100. This phenomenon, driven mainly by climate change, is caused by two fundamental mechanisms: seawater thermal expansion and ice sheets and glaciers melting. Thermal expansion occurs when water heats up and expands. As global temperatures rise, the ocean absorbs more heat, causing significant water expansion. In parallel, the melting of ice sheets in Greenland, Antarctica, and other glaciers around the world contributes to a further rise in sea level. At the rate at which the planet's poles are melting, we can observe a drastic change in the shape of these regions. Although the planet has experienced these changes in the past, human activity is currently accelerating and worsening global warming. This is mainly due to the emission of greenhouse gases caused by the burning of fossil fuels, deforestation, and other industrial and agricultural practices. The impact of sea level rise on coastal cities and low-lying regions of the world will be devastating. Densely populated cities such as New York, Miami, Tokyo, Mumbai, and Shanghai face serious threats. For example, much of Florida's coastline in the United States could be submerged. In Asia, countries like Bangladesh, which are already facing flood problems, would see vast swaths of their territory underwater, displacing millions of people. The Caribbean region and the Pacific Islands are among the most vulnerable. Small island nations like the Maldives and Tuvalu are at risk of disappearing completely, resulting in a physical loss of territory and a humanitarian and cultural crisis. In addition, regions near large river deltas such as the Nile Delta in Egypt and the Mekong Delta in Vietnam will face frequent and severe flooding, affecting agriculture and infrastructure and forcing large populations to migrate. The consequences for humanity will be devastating. The displacement of millions of people will give rise to a new category of climate refugees. Coastal cities must invest huge resources in mitigation and adaptation measures, such as building dikes and barriers, raising infrastructure, and creating advanced drainage systems. However, in many cases, these measures may be insufficient or unsustainable in the long term, and eventually nations will have to make the hard decision to relocate the population of the affected cities. This could mean large cities full of buildings and skyscrapers could be abandoned due to rising sea levels. Can you imagine a city like New York empty with the streets under seawater? Because of this, we will see how geographers would have to completely redraw coastlines, as rising water levels would create new bays. Places that are empty and free of humans today may become future settlements for climate refugees. Significantly higher areas, such as those found in much of Africa or Tibet. It is possible that before 2100 we will see large cities far from the coasts, but only time will tell. Let's hope by then humans will have done something to slow climate change and prevent these changes from affecting future generations. 4. Melting permafrost. Permafrost is a permanently frozen layer of soil found primarily in the Arctic and subarctic regions of the Northern Hemisphere. Its melting has profound implications for the environment, infrastructure, and society. The main driver of permafrost melting is, again, climate change. Rising global temperatures caused by the accumulation of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere due to human activities such as burning fossil fuels and deforestation are accelerating warming in the polar regions. This warming is thawing the permafrost at an alarming rate and will bring several direct consequences. When permafrost thaws, it releases large amounts of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide and methane, trapped in frozen soil for thousands of years. These gases have a very high global warming potential, mainly methane, which is about 25 times more potent than carbon dioxide. This process creates a positive feedback loop, where heating releases more gases, accelerating warming. Thawing permafrost has a significant impact on infrastructure in affected regions. In Siberia, Alaska, and Canada, many communities and cities are located just above the permafrost. So, if it melts, the ground becomes unstable, causing the collapse of buildings, roads, pipes, and other types of infrastructure. Cities such as Norilsk in Russia and Fairbanks in Alaska could face serious challenges that could, at best, slightly alter the terrain, and at worst, completely modify them by turning solid ground into muddy pits where it would be impossible to walk or build, forcing their inhabitants to move to areas without permafrost. Melting permafrost has global implications in addition to local impacts. The release of methane and carbon dioxide will contribute to global warming, worsening extreme weather events worldwide. Rising temperatures could lead to more heat waves, droughts, and floods, affecting agriculture and the availability of drinking water. Indigenous communities living in permafrost regions will also be severely affected. These communities depend on the frozen ground for their traditional way of life, including hunting and fishing. The melting ice will transform local ecosystems, altering animal migratory routes and affecting biodiversity. This change will force many communities to abandon their ancestral homes and adapt to new environments, changing the geographical and cultural distribution of these populations, or even causing their disappearance. As permafrost melts, new areas of the Arctic will become accessible, opening up possibilities for the exploration and exploitation of natural resources such as oil, gas, and minerals. This could lead to geopolitical disputes over sovereignty and control of these newly accessible regions, redrawing international and maritime borders. We will see a significant transformation in the Arctic regions in terms of map changes. Due to thawing permafrost and shrinking sea ice, new shipping lanes could open up in the Arctic, allowing northern countries to establish permanent Arctic shipping routes. Consequently, geographical maps will need to be updated to reflect these changes and the new boundaries of habitable land and exploitable resources. Can you imagine a future where the Arctic will be the busiest shipping lane in the world? Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. 3. New islands. Although it seemed impossible in the past, we know that the emergence of new islands takes relatively little time. Islands can arise artificially by humans or naturally by the emergence of volcanoes. In both cases, new islands have the potential to significantly change the maps of the world before 2100. Let's start with the artificial islands humans can create. The creation of artificial islands has gained notoriety in recent decades. Countries such as China and the United Arab Emirates have carried out ambitious land reclamation and island-building projects. For example, the Palm Islands in Dubai and the artificial islands in the South China Sea are notable examples of how humans can turn areas initially part of the sea or ocean into firm, habitable ground. The creation of artificial islands can significantly alter maritime and territorial boundaries. These islands expand a country's sovereign territory and extend its exclusive economic zones, EEZs, allowing control over fishery resources and potential oil and gas reserves. Artificial islands can also have severe environmental impacts, including destroying coral reefs and marine habitats. In addition, changing ocean currents and sedimentation patterns can affect adjacent coastlines and marine biodiversity. If in the future more countries adopt this practice of creating artificial islands, land and sea maps will need to be updated to reflect these new formations. We must also consider that islands can also appear naturally. The emergence of natural islands is a less common but equally significant process resulting from volcanic activity. Underwater eruptions can give rise to new islands, as has historically happened with islands such as Surtsey in Iceland, which emerged in 1963. New volcanic islands can transform the ocean landscape. These islands emerge quickly and can provide new habitats for wildlife. However, volcanic eruptions can also be destructive, causing tsunamis and altering nearby marine ecosystems. The emergence of a new volcanic island in a densely populated region could have disastrous consequences for coastal cities such as Tokyo or Honolulu. The emergence of new volcanic islands may offer new opportunities for scientific exploration and human colonization. However, they can also be high-risk areas due to ongoing volcanic activity. The accessibility and habitability of these islands will depend on their geological stability and the available resources. If they are islands with high volcanic activity, surely very few countries will want to claim them. But if they are natural islands with little or no volcanic activity, many nations will want to take them over. If new islands emerge in the coming years, geographical and natural maps will have to be updated to include them. And in some cases, countries could increase their territory. People could even move to those new islands and build cities where previously there was only ocean. 2. Deserts disappear. This change can occur in two scenarios. An artificial one caused by human reforestation and engineering projects, and a natural one caused by the melting of the poles and the advance of the sea inland. Both scenarios have profound implications for the planet's geography. Desert reforestation involves the implementation of vast engineering and reforestation projects. Advanced irrigation technologies, seawater desalinization, and planting plant species resistant to the arid climate can transform desert areas into fertile land. China has already begun work on similar projects such as the Great Green Wall to curb desertification. The transformation of deserts into forest and agricultural land would drastically change the world's physical map. Areas such as the Sahara Desert, the Gobi Desert, and parts of the Arabian Desert could turn green, altering the local and regional climate. The new forests would increase biodiversity, restore habitats, and contribute to carbon sequestration, mitigating climate change. Cities like Riyadh and Abu Dhabi could benefit significantly from these projects, transforming themselves into agricultural and biodiversity hubs. Geographic maps would show the conversion of vast expanses of deserts into green lands, affecting country borders and the distribution of natural resources. However, the melting of the poles and the rise in sea level due to climate change also could flood low-lying areas of the deserts, such as parts of the Sahara that are below sea level. The flooding of deserts would drastically change the geography of these regions, transforming them into new bodies of water. This would alter local ecosystems, creating new aquatic habitats and changing biodiversity dynamics. The Sahara, for example, could see the formation of lakes inland. The transformation of deserts into bodies of water would have significant repercussions for nearby cities and communities. Cities such as Cairo and Tripoli, which rely on desert resources and are close to low-lying areas, could face challenges due to relocation and adaptation to new environments. Geographical maps would show the transformation of extensive desert areas into lakes and inland seas, redefining land and sea borders. Can you imagine that on the maps of the future where the Sahara Desert is currently located, there will be a huge lake surrounded by forests and jungles? 1. New seas. This is related to all of the above points. The creation of new lakes and seas could occur artificially by human intervention or naturally due to the melting of the poles and the advance of the sea inland. This phenomenon can potentially significantly alter the world's maps by 2100. These scenarios could have profound implications for geography, ecology, and human society. Engineering projects such as building dams or diverting rivers to flood large areas could artificially create new lakes and seas. Creating new lakes and seas would radically change the topography and hydrology of the affected regions. Dry and desert areas could become expansive bodies of water, creating new aquatic habitats and modifying local weather patterns. Although it may seem impossible, humans can do something like this. In the past, the Aral Sea was one of the most essential seas in Asia, but due to human efforts, we turned that huge sea into a desert without water. If we could dry up a sea, we can definitely create one too. However, this would have positive and negative consequences. On the one hand, it could provide opportunities for economic development through fishing and shipping. On the other hand, it could displace local communities and cause the loss of agricultural land, human settlements, or ultimately the extinction of species, as happened with the Beiji, a freshwater dolphin from the Yangtze River that became extinct in 2006 when the Three Gorges Dam was built in China. This gigantic prey destroyed the habitat of this animal, leading to its extinction. Naturally, melting the poles and rising sea levels due to climate change could cause low-lying coastal areas to flood and create new seas. This could occur as meltwater pours into the ocean, raising sea levels and moving inland. The natural creation of new seas would drastically change coastal geography, transforming previously dry areas into coastal bodies of water. This would significantly impact coastal ecosystems, including the loss of terrestrial habitats and the flooding of low-lying areas. An example of this scenario could be the flooding of parts of Bangladesh's coast. Rising sea levels could create new inland seas as they move inland, affecting cities such as Dhaka and Chittagong. Coastal cities and communities in affected areas could lose land, infrastructure, and natural resources. This could result in population relocations and completely change the maps of the flooded areas. Imagine that a series of all these events will co-occur in the future. How do you think the maps of the world will change? Now we want to know your opinion. Do you think, in 2100, the maps of the entire planet will differ significantly from the current ones? Let us know what you think in the comments.